Josh comes to us after transferring from Tulane, where he played for two seasons. He graduated Northfield Mount Hermon in 2013 and helped lead them to a prep school national championship. Josh is a very versatile player. I think his versatility almost worked against him a little bit at Tulane. I don't know if they knew exactly how to use him. I think he can play the one through the four. A tremendous defender, high basketball IQ. Coming out of Harvard-Westlake, he committed to Utah before a serious knee injury led him to Northfield Mount Hermon. Visited many Atlantic 10 and American Conference schools. He's going to be a big part of this year's team, making our guys better in practice, along with his former and current teammate, Peyton Henson. But both those guys will be important for us, give us some depth in practice, and really make our guys better while also learning our system. Trey Bell-Haynes had a huge freshman year for us, incredibly explosive, can get to the basket, make plays for himself and others, has an incredible knack for finishing around the rim. Last year, as a freshman point guard, he was prone to turnovers and had some games where he turned it over too much, and that's something that he's really worked on in the offseason. He also is learning to play at different speeds. Last year, we thought he played at one speed too much, so we're really trying to work with him to play at different speeds. But he had a tremendous freshman year. He's had a great offseason, worked on his jump shot. So now if teams want to go under ball screens with him, he really feels confident that he can make teams pay. So he's a great defensive player, really buys into our system. I think he's going to have a tremendous sophomore year and really looking forward to him leading us again this year. David was a freshman walk-on last year, came to us late. He was enrolled here as a student before he contacted us. With his class schedule, with his living all the way across campus on Trinity campus, he really had a lot to overcome in joining our team late, but he did a great job. Kid from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and really kind of embodies a lot of that blue-collar mentality. Works really hard day in and day out for us. He's gotten better. He's here all summer working with our guys. And he's a valuable piece to our team. The guys really respect him. Coaches really respect him. David's got to be ready to play and take advantage of any opportunities that may come his way this year. We're really excited about Dylan joining us from Middlebury College just down the street as a graduate student who's here all summer with us and continues to get better here through our fall workouts. He's kind of a tweener, about 6'4", 6'5". He's playing a little bit of the three, a little bit of four, you know, two positions that we really don't have a lot of depth. So, you know, we're hoping that Dylan can provide some scoring, punch off the bench, can provide energy, you know, rebound it at a high level at Middlebury, along with scoring the ball. He's experienced, he's played a lot of college games, and we're hoping that he can be someone to provide some depth for us and give us a little bit of everything. We're really excited Dylan's here and think he's going to be a big part of our team this year. Darren is eligible after sitting out last year after transferring from Hofstra. You know, a kid that I've known for a long time. We recruited him out of high school. They actually took one of his official visits out of high school here to Vermont. So we're really happy to get him on the transfer market. He had a good year last year learning our system, learning our culture. He's really come a long way with his year off and really took advantage to get stronger, to improve his skill set, to really get acclimated to what we're doing here in Vermont. His talent is undeniable. He's 6'8", 220-pound lefty. He scores at a high level, catch and finish opportunities, and we think he can be really effective in our league, maybe one of the most athletic guys in our league, a shot blocker around the rim. So with him and Ethan O'Day in there, we have two guys we really think can protect the rim. And, you know, he looks much more comfortable now in our system, and we're expecting big things from Darren this year. Cam had a great freshman year, ended up being the co-sixth man of the year in the America East Conference last year. Can really shoot the ball, can play both guard positions. Cam's versatility in the backcourt's really going to be key to us, being able to play on and off the ball. He's put on 10 pounds in the offseason, so I think now he's 155 pounds soaking wet. He looks a little bit bigger, and that will help him get through the rigors of the college season. Real excited about Cam going into his sophomore year. He has a much better understanding of what it takes to be successful. He got better as the year went on last year. He's continued that into our summer program, and he just looks like a different kid this fall, confident, bigger, stronger, knows what he needs to do, and he should be, again, a big piece of our team this year. Ernie's been cleared to play full contact live basketball after about 8 months off. And we're really excited about getting Ernie back. In 50 minutes last year with a serious back injury, we caught a glimpse of what he's going to be for us. Per 40 minutes last year, he was on pace average, close to 8 assists. I'm just really happy for Ernie. He's a basketball junkie. kid that really, like all our kids, really wants to play basketball. And, you know, to be out 8 months, and it's really tough to see him go through that, to see the smile on his face again and to see him working out and playing basketball has really lifted everyone's spirits on the team. And, you know, we expect him to be a big part of our program. Whether he comes off the bench or starts, he's going to play a lot of minutes and be a decision maker for us. And we're really happy that Ernie's back. Obviously, the younger brother of Ernie Duncan comes to us from Evansville Harrison High School. Everett is the all-time leading scorer at Evansville Harrison High School. Averaged 22 points a game, led the state of Indiana in scoring for much of his senior year. You know, at 6'6", he's got good size. Hopefully, he can provide some depth on the wing. He really is a good offensive player, has a really good feel for the game, can shoot the ball, just has a knack for scoring the ball. He's got to get stronger and get used to the speed and athleticism of the college game. But, you know, he's really effective this summer. And I think Everett has that same potential to be a guy that, you know, has to get stronger, but still is going to be able to be effective for us. And it should be interesting to see what kind of role Everett can work out on this team. So we're excited to see that. Dre Wills took a huge jump last year and just had a huge year for us. You know, he battled through a foot injury for the second part of the season that really limited his practice time. We decided to just basically shut him down for the summer. He just worked on his form shooting off with an assistant coach on the side with the goal of getting him healthy, because we know what we have with Dre. If we can keep him healthy, he's going to be potentially defensive player of the year, and again, an all-league caliber player. You know, I've said it before, he's a kind of our alpha dog. He's our guy that's going to, we know he's going to compete every night, give us that edge that we like to play with. And we expect another jump from him again this year in leading our team on and off the court. Drew spent the summer playing with Team Canada in the FIBA U19 World Championships over in Greece again, the second summer in a row he spent with Team Canada, getting invaluable international experience. After not playing a lot early in his freshman year, we gave Drew extended minutes in our postseason run in the CBI last year, and I thought he really started to show signs of what he can be. He's lost some weight, he's fit, he looks like he lost some baby weight from his freshman year, and has been playing really hard, and his skill set and talent is undeniable. With Drew, we've always talked about consistency day in and day out. Really confident that he's going to be able to do that this year and really be one of those guys that makes a huge jump from his freshman and sophomore year and have a breakout year for us. It's hard to believe, but this is his senior year, and you know, he's our first team all-league guy from last year and arguably one of the best players in our conference. Ethan's going to have to stay out of foul trouble. I thought he got better with that towards the end of last season, but something we're really going to have to focus on, keeping him out on the court. Offensively, really has developed a nice face-up game, can score away from the basket, and then can score obviously around the basket with both hands. So he's continued to refine his offensive game, but it's really going to be his leadership and his savviness that's going to be important for us this year, and really being our go-to guy this year. We got to be able to depend on Ethan night in and night out to be on the court and to deliver for us. And he's done a great job leading this group this summer and into the fall, but we expect Ethan to be our leader again this year. Kurt had a great sophomore year, did not shoot the ball as well as he did his freshman year, but is still currently the all-time leader in three-point field goal percentage at the University of Vermont. He's had a full off season to work on his game. Injuries the last two off seasons have prevented him from really getting in the gym. He's been working on his game as hard as anyone in our program, and he's really improved putting the ball down on the floor, scoring around the basket. He's really becoming a complete offensive player. From his freshman to sophomore year, he got so much better defensively, and has now become one of our better defenders, and really is dependable to execute our game plan, game in and game out. And so I'm really happy he's had an offseason. Kid loves getting in the gym and working on his game, and he's been able to do that this offseason. Kurt should have a great year for us. Peyton Henson is the second guy for us to transfer from Tulane, a skilled big guy, really productive at Tulane and in the American Conference, and a guy that we think is really going to be a stat stuffer for us here also. He's a really good shooter. We're really trying to make him a great shooter in his year off, because if he can develop that, it's really going to set up his game for him. We're really going to work on him rebounding the ball better for us. Peyton's going to be a really good player, really dependable, really solid. We see that translating his skill set to our level, to our program, to our system And so I'm real excited to have Peyton and really looking forward to what he's going to do as a Catamount, you know, over the next 3 years. You know, Nate's a great story. He's grew up in Underhill, Vermont. Eighth grade, he moved out to California to San Jose. His dad got a job at Apple. Nate went to high school out in California and then kind of was a late bloomer and wanted to continue his basketball career out on the East Coast. Kids go to prep schools out on the West Coast. Not as many prep schools, so kids usually end up at junior college. A top student, 4.0 student, computer science major. A kid that did really well at junior college and really fits kind of how we play, especially how we want our four men to play. He's really skilled. He can shoot it out to three. He can put the ball on the floor. He's still going through an adjustment period now, but he's a hard worker. He's a really smart kid, and so we see him getting better every single day through workouts. We're really happy to have him. He's going to give us more depth up front and a guy that's going to get an opportunity this year. We look forward to having Nate for the next 3 years.